Today you're going to create a short slideshow to show what you know about three helpful tech tips. These are things we will use all the time in class, and now you'll be the one teaching them. So here's your Google slide, and you'll notice you have four slides in your film strip. The very first thing you want to do is add your name. So click right there and just type your name. So your first slide is about how to fix the volume if your sound is not working. The text is already written for you. Your job is to add at least one image, maybe of a keyboard or volume key or headphones with a knob. You're going to need to insert images. Make sure you just click right here where it says replace image, and then you can search the web and type here in the search bar, and you can look for a picture that corresponds to your slide. Don't forget, when you type your word, you have to press enter to make sure it will start your search. And then you can insert by clicking and then press replace, and then that image will appear in your image holder. Next is a slide about capital letters and symbols. You'll read the explanation and then add an image, maybe a keyboard, or an example like shift plus 2 equals the at symbol. Your last slide is about the refresh button, the one that looks like a little arrow in a circle. You'll add an image that shows where the button is or what it looks like. You're only adding two things to each slide: a helpful image and a background design that looks clear and fun. So remember, to click on a background, you want to make sure you click on the slide over here on the left in the film strip. Then click background, and you can choose a color, or you can also choose an image. Go to Google Images for that search. And you might just want to do something like a border, and that way it won't interfere with what is on your slide. You don't want to put pictures on your slide that will cover up the words. So you can just find a border that you might like. Make sure it is going horizontal across, and then you can press insert. And then you have your own border. If you want that border to go on every single page, just click Add to Theme, and there it is. When you finish, check your work, and then you can turn it in to Google Classroom. And that's it. I'll catch you next time.